Hi everyone, today we talk about lone worker alarms on W-AIR DECT system. W-AIR DECT system can be installed in locations where people work alone. And this particular handset is called Lifesaver. Here is why. It supports five types of alarms, three of which can be generated automatically, such as no movement, running, and man down. Imagine a person works alone in a warehouse or on a construction site, and in case they fall down, there is no one to help them and to see it. The handset that they carry on them can generate the alarm automatically and call for help. Starting from WMS release 502, not only can we know which handset generated the alarm, but we can also know the type of alarm that was triggered and the exact location of the handset, which means we can know the exact location of the person who needs help. Let's see it in action.
Alarm man down triggered in the conference room.
How do we achieve it? Well, we know which base station was the closest one to the handset the moment the alarm was triggered. The handset has the information about the RSSI levels. These levels indicate which base station is the closest one to the handset. Now let's see how to set it up. Here are the requirements. WMS 502 and in particular the W-AIR firmware 501B5. W-AIR network already set up with alarms. I remind you that the alarms must be set up on the W-AIR base station's interface, and you can read our documentation for details. And most importantly, a hardware or a virtual PBX only, no cloud for this setup. The first step is to open the interface of our primary W-AIR base station, tap management and enable text messaging. Set our PBX as the messaging and alarm server and set the messaging port 9300. Save and reboot the base station. Now let's open the menu alarms. Here, I have previously configured several alarm profiles. So make sure you change the alarm signal from call to message. Save. The second step is to open the terminal on our PBX and edit the file alarm.template. Inside, you will see the prompts that help you edit the file. The dial plan context and the called number is already specified here. This means we will need to create a new dial plan and name it alarm-WAIR. And in this dial plan, we will need to specify the called number alarms. One more thing to do from the terminal is to start the WAIR alarm service on the PBX and to enable it permanently using these two commands. Now let's work on our dial plan. First of all, make sure you add the called number alarms and specify where exactly the alarm should be sent. For example, an extension number or a call group. The second thing is to make sure we can differentiate between our base stations. As you see, I have here two additional called numbers, 00X and 04X. The first two digits, 00 and 04, allow me to differentiate between the two base stations. I have two base stations in my W-AIR installation. 00 and 04 are the RPNs of these base stations. How do I find the RPN? On the base's interface, here it is. I will use dynamic text-to-speech to generate differentiated messages for the operator. I remind you that you need at least one premium license to use the TTS text-to-speech feature. You can also use some pre-recorded messages uploaded via the sounds menu. Now, what if I also want to pass the type of the alarm? For that, I will use the last digit in the code numbers, the X. We have 5 alarm types. Each alarm type has its own ID. So instead of X, we need to add the ID of our alarm type. I have 2 types of alarms configured on my W-AIR interface, man down and the red button. Man down alarm has the ID 0. Red key has the ID 4. So this is what I need to use instead of X as the last digit in my code numbers. I have added my dial plan, and right now I have 4 code numbers instead of 2. The first 2 digits stand for the RPN of the base station. The last digit stands for the type of the alarm. And of course I had to edit my messages for the operator. So right now under 000 I have alarm man down triggered in the conference room. The base station 00 is located in the conference room. Under 004 I have red button alarm triggered in the conference room. Under 040 the base station 04 is located in the marketing office. I have alarm man down triggered in the marketing office, and under 044 I have red button alarm triggered in the marketing office. Now let's give it a try. This is the conference room. The W-AIR MAT handset is assigned to the user Yelena. I press the button and the operator receives the alarm.
Red button alarm triggered in the conference room.
Now let's try the W-AIR Lifesaver.
Alarm man down triggered in the conference room.
Now let's do the same from the marketing office.
Red button alarm triggered in the marketing office. Alarm man down triggered in the marketing office. Red button alarm triggered in the marketing office.
That's it for today. Thanks for watching. Please give it a try and let us know what you think about this life-saving feature.